Hello and welcome to PDFSupply.com. Today we're going to be testing a 9030 processor. I have here an IC693 CPU363 and I have it attached to an IC693 CHS397 5 slot rack, which is empty. Slots 2 through 5 need to be empty for this test. It's just a simple test on the processor. And it's being powered by a high capacity power supply. This is our IC693 PWR330. So the first thing I'm going to do in the test is power it up. And I'm looking for an OK light, a solid OK light, which indicates to me that the processor is ready for a test, that there's nothing immediately wrong with the processor. So if you don't have a light here, or if your light is blinking, then it's very likely you have a major problem with the processor. And this is something that we typically look at and we repair here. We also offer exchange programs, new products, and remanufactured. So if that's something that interests you or you need, please see us at pdfsupply.com. So now that it's powered up, I'm going to connect up to the processor. I'm in Prophecy Machine Edition. And the first thing I'm going to do is get it to programmer mode. And go to target, offline commands, then clear. Only controller fault table and IO fault table. The bottom two selections, controller fault table and IO fault table. I don't want to clear anything else because there may be information that I don't want to lose in the memory. So I'm going to go ahead and say OK to that. And keep in mind that when you, under the main rack where the software configuration is for your hardware configuration, slots 2 through 5 need to be empty, just like the you see it here. And that way we won't make any faults. So I'm going to go ahead and download and run this information. What I'm trying to do here is get the processor into run mode. If I can get the processor into run mode, it's likely that it's a good working processor. If it can't go into run mode, then we know that there's a problem. So now it's asking me what to download to the controller. We want to download hardware configuration and logic. So I'm going to OK that. I'll let this build continue. Right. Now keep in mind, you see here I have my on-off switch in the off position. And there's a reason for that I'm going to get to in just a second here. This switch does two functions for us. This is a memory protect switch. When this is on, the memory is protected. The second thing is that it's an I/O enabled switch. Okay, so it's asked me if I want to enable the outputs. Yes, but it shouldn't do that until I actually physically turn the switch. So I'm going to get an error that says the controller is not in run mode after you attempted to start it. This may be due to the run stop switch position application. It's true. So now when I turn this key, I should get a run light, and I do. So I know that this is functioning properly. Okay, so now the next two things I want to test, of course, is port number 2, port number 1. I do it in kind of reverse order because I already have this cable working. And incidentally, this is an AS693232 SNP. Cable that I'm using. I'm going to disconnect that, flip it over, and plug it in. I'm looking for the port 2 LED to start blinking, and it has. So I know that's a functioning port. Next one is this port. This is a little different looking. The part number here is an IC693CBL316. I have on one side what looks kind of like a phone jack. All right, and on the other side there's a serial port like this. I'm going to plug into my computer. So go ahead and plug into port 1, and on the other side you can't see, I'm going to be plugging into the computer. And of course I'm looking for the LED to start blinking, port 1 to tell me that it's functioning, and it is. So that pretty much concludes the test. So what I would recommend, if this is a processor that you feel is giving you a problem, what I would do normally is leave it running overnight or over a couple days, usually over a weekend. And what I'm trying to make sure is that this processor is able to keep itself in run mode. If for some reason I come in after a couple days and the processor is, this LED is off like that, then it wasn't able to keep itself in run mode. There's a problem still. So what you could do is go into Prophecy Machine Edition under Target, subcategory Diagnostics. Your info viewer will present you with a fault table, and the fault table will tell you why it jumped out of run mode. And sometimes the explanations are not very understandable that they put in the fault table. Sometimes they are. But again, if it does kick itself out of run mode, you have a problem with the processor. And again, this is something that we do look at and we do repair frequently. We offer remanufactured products, new products, and even exchange programs. So if that's something that interests you, please see us at pdfsupply.com. Thank you.